7, 6, 5, 4, 3.
Ghosts. How did I suddenly start knowing about ghosts? All my life up till now, I never saw a ghost. I never knew anything about them. Now, I know that a ghost is a failure. A ghost is a defeat. A ghost is a remnant. It's what's left behind when you go away and you haven't the strength to take all of yourself with you. No wonder people are afraid of ghosts. You see a ghost, and you know it could happen to you. You could lose part of yourself, all of yourself. You could end up transparent, no strength to move, no strength to get away, not even wanting to get away. Because a ghost is what hangs on. A ghost is what can't let go. I don't know what this is that's happening now, but I never went looking for it. It came, looking for me.
Dear Mr. Quilling, I produce a series called Leap in the Dark, a television series that examines the paranormal. I'm writing to you because I wondered if you had experienced some event that you would consider writing about. Could be anything that's usually considered paranormal, haunting, telepathy, poltergeists, etc. Alternatively, we could share some of our research with you. There might be incidents and places in our files that would interest you. Yours sincerely, Michael Croucher, producer.
After he died, and it went on for 2 or 3 months, night after night, breathing by my bedside. I said to one of my friends I was getting a bit afraid to go upstairs. I hated it so much. Although I knew it might be my husband, I was rather frightened. So she said, well, why don't you tell him it's frightening you? So the next time I heard it, I thanked him very much for coming, and I appreciated it. But I said, you know, really, you are frightening me to death. And after that, he never came again.
Extraordinary. Do you think there's something in this house that is particularly retentive of, what would you call it, spiritual essences?
all the old brick.
The brick?
Yes. Clay. And what are we all but clay, really?
And the clay holds them, you think? The clay brings them back?
I don't say it brings them back. I think it's the impression, having once been made, it makes it easier for them to show themselves. The roundhead, the cavalier, my husband, and the girl in white.
Who was she, do you think? From what time does she come?
Oh, goodness, I've no idea. I've no idea at all.
Where in the house does she appear?
Always in the upstairs hall.
Have you been seeing her ever since you've been in this house, or was there a particular time when she first began to appear?
She wasn't here at first. It wasn't until we'd been here a year or two that we first began to see her.
All of you saw her?
Yes. My husband and I. And the girl as well. We all saw her.
What girl was that?
My daughter. She wouldn't say anything about it at first. But she finally did admit that she saw her as well.
How old was she then, your daughter?
Oh, 14. Possibly 15.
Now she's grown up and gone away?
Yes, she's married. She has a daughter of her own now. Can I pour you another cup of tea?
Yes, please. Thank you. Is she happy?
Sorry,
I don't know why I said that. I wasn't even thinking it.
Her husband's an accountant. Does rather well. Surprising, though. Not the sort of man you would have expected her to marry.
Savonarola?
Yes. The man who made a bonfire of the vanities.
Feels different here. The atmosphere isn't the same as downstairs. I feel different here. There's an ache in my throat. As if I'm going to cry.
Oh, dear. Are you a sensitive?
Not as far as I know. Are you a Catholic?
No. But we've always had the mother and child in the house.
Whose room was this?
It was my daughter's room.
And where is she now?
She lives in Clevedon. I'll show you the back stairs. They go up to the loft. Several people have said they felt themselves being pushed downstairs.
It's lovely here, but I don't want to be caught jumping out the window and my trousers are meow.
Plenty of time yet. It's still early. And it isn't lovely here. It's a stupid room. It's a stupid house. In our old house, I had my own place. I had my attic. That was where I slept. Everything's different in this house. I mean, well, this room is just a room you walk through to get from one side of the house to the other. It isn't high up. It isn't a special place. And it'll never be mine. It feels as if they're walking through me.
Daft. Nobody's walking through you. If you need a special place, you've got me. I'll always be a special place.
You say that and maybe you believe it, but I don't. Look, anyhow, nobody can be somebody else's special place. A place is something you have to have without anyone else. If you don't have a place to be, then you have nothing to hang on to. I suppose really strong people have their own special place in themselves. They don't need anything else. They don't need a room. But I do. I'm not strong.
I'll be strong for you.
When you hug me, is there as much of me as there was?
What do you mean? You've been trying to slim?
I mean, there must be less of me if there's more of her.
More of who?
Your laugh. You won't believe it. At first there was hardly anything. Just the very faintest drifting smoke. Only it wasn't drifting. It was staying in the same shape. So faint it was, you could hardly see it. You could see right through it.
Oh, come in, unstuck you are. You're going right round the twist. You want to get out of this house.
Now she's much clearer. Much sharper. You can make her out quite plainly, except that you can't see her face. She's always got her face turned away. She's got on this white dress like Alice in Wonderland. White stockings, little black shoes with a strap and button. Proper little virgin she is. Well, that's how they want me to be. That's why she looks like that.
I don't understand. Are you talking about some kind of ghost or what?
Yes. I'm talking about some kind of ghost.
Can you feel anything here?
No, can you?
Not at the moment, no.
This is where people have felt themselves being pushed down the stairs.
Quite a few people have said that, yes. And my daughter absolutely refused to use these stairs after a time.
Have you ever had anything happen to you on these stairs?
Well, I'll tell you something quite remarkable. Do you know anything about historical regression?
Under hypnosis, you mean?
That's it. Well, it was quite remarkable what happened to me under hypnosis. I was a young girl living in this house during the time of the Civil War, and my name was Clarissa. I was on these stairs, and there was a round head. It was the very same man we've seen a ghost of in this house. Such an ugly man. With a surly, stubbly face. I can remember his face so clearly. He was after me. And I was running up the stairs to the loft. I could hear him behind me, hear his breathing. But there were pigeons in the loft. They used to keep pigeons there. And the pigeons were all fluttering about. And beating him with their wings.
What happened then?
He went away. He went downstairs again. He didn't bother me anymore.
The pigeons drove him off, you mean?
I couldn't say, really. I don't know. Certainly he was startled by them. Then he was gone.
Near thing.
It's just as much of you as there ever was.
You think it's funny. It's all just a joke to you. You just don't know what it's like. I'm being defeated.
Oh, what's she doing to you? Is she making you sit in the ashes while she goes to the ball?
There's no use talking to you about it. It's all little slanty things, nothing straight. Like there was a skirt I wanted, and she said it looked a little sluttish, dear. She doesn't want me to grow into a woman.
You're hardly going to grow into a man, but the way you are.
Oh, yes, you can joke.
We'll go away.
I'm 15. She'll have the police after us.
Well, next year, then.
Next year, it'll be too late. Next year, there won't be enough of me left. This house is stronger than I am. It's her house.
Maybe this will make it a bit more your house.
Yes. Make me stronger. Make me realer. I don't want to be a ghost.
And of course, there was a priest hide. You can see the opening there.
In Clevedon, you say she lives now, your daughter?
Yes.
Could I have a telephone number, please? I think I'd like to talk to her.
About our ghosts, do you mean?
Yes, about the ghosts.
I don't think you'll get much out of her. She's not much of a talker, you know.
Well, I don't like to rule out any possibilities. Drink gin, please.
Tonic?
Nothing else, thank you, just the gin.
Well, as I told you on the phone, she's been gone since yesterday, and I haven't the faintest idea where. She didn't turn up at her mother's while you were there.
Well, if she did, I didn't see her. You rung the police?
Not yet.
She's done this before?
No. I've always been expecting it. Are you in love with her?
Well, how could I be in love with her? I've never even laid eyes on her.
Sorry, I don't know why I said that. I wasn't even thinking it.
Don't even know what she looks like.
Who's room was this? my daughter's room.
And where is she now?
She has her candle.
I'm as far as I know.
I wouldn't dare make up anything like that. It's such an obvious device. A voice that turns up on a tape which nobody heard when the recording was being made. Well, is it the mother? Or could it be the daughter? Well, whoever it is, how'd they get on the tape? I really don't know what to make of it. I wasn't looking for any phenomena other than what normally goes on between parents and children. That's spooky enough without anything extra. I really don't know what to make of it.
Nor do I. I was coming up to London in any case, and I must admit I am most curious to hear it.
Whose room was this? Hello! It was my daughter's room.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to upset you. Truly, I didn't. I just thought you'd like to hear the tape, that's all. I didn't think beyond that.
That's all right.
Is it your voice?
I have no idea. No idea at all. Thank you so much for letting me hear the tape.
I got off my tape then. It's you, poor ghost of a girl that lost some kind of a battle in this house. Ghost of a poor girl who isn't dead, only grown up and gone away and left you here to cry out in the shadows. Poor ghost. Not strong enough to leave your place of defeat. Was it you that gathered all your feeble strength together? Put it into that cry and got onto my tape and out of this house? Is that it? Am I right? Is it you that's come away?
Sweet, sweet, come and find me. Sweet, 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 come and find me. Sweet, my love and sweet, my kisses. Sweet, my that and sweet, my this is. Where the shadows dance in the dark, would come to me and chance what your heart would. Where the night flies up on its dark wings, come to me and bring what your heart brings. Sweet, sweet, come and kiss me. Sweet, sweet, do not miss me. Sweet, sweet, come and kiss me. Sweet, sweet, never miss me. Sweet, the rising of the night. Yes, yes, rise at night. Sweet, the morning still and bright. Loving morning still and bright. Loving morning, come to the light. Quick, quick, come and find me. Quick, 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 come and find me. Dancing, dancing here in the greenwood. Never dancing in the same wood. Quick, quick, come and find me. Quick, 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 come and find me. Quick, quick, come and find me. Quick, 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 come and find me. Come and find me. Come and find me. Come and find me. Come and find me.
Where do you want to go? You want to join up with the rest of yourself? You must want that. That's why you came away from that house. All right, I'll take you where you want to go. Where do you want to go?
worst of me happened. This is where the best of me happened. This is the place I'll come back to.
Why'd you always say creepy things like that? We're gonna have a real place of our own.
This is our first place. Our best place.
Is this the place? Is this where the rest of you is? The rest of you is alive. The rest of you isn't a ghost. Where are you?
Whose room was this?
That's it. She's gone. Where? It was you, wasn't it? Wasn't it? Tell me, please. Was it not you?
Too late.
Her husband did ring the police on the second day. So far they haven't found her.
She won't come back to him.
Where do you think she'll turn up?
I don't know. But I don't think he'll be the one to find her.
I say, Henry, you're not getting...
Transparent?
Transparent. That's very good. I must say I feel pretty strange about all this. Who would have thought all this would happen when I wrote to you?
Who would have thought? I don't think she'll come back to him. I don't think he'll be the one that'll find her.